Erwin Kashitheu, Oshinene Constituency Councillor, noted that Kahangoro was the face of the Oshinene Village Council and it was befitting to honor him through a dignified burial. Kashitheu says they consulted various stakeholders from the health ministry, law enforcement agencies and the judiciary to bring this matter to conclusion.
Last year in December when we buried Mr. Kahangoro, it was a very tough decision to bury him in Hobabes. We were all not prepared because he was the first to die, to pass on within the constituency. And it wasn't easy for us, the family, and everybody else because Mr. Kahangoro was known as the face of Oshinene. Whatever he did back then made him so popular that everybody, when he passed on, everybody wanted him to be buried, wanted to bury him. But unfortunately, due to the COVID-19 protocols, we couldn't bury him in Oshinene. And it became something to say we all want him to be buried back home and laid to rest. That's why today it's a very historic big day to all the constituents of Oshinene.
Veta Ruhe Kandorodhu, a former Okakarara councillor and a family friend, said that late Kahangoro was a formidable man who transformed Oshinene settlement to a village council. Kandorodhu noted that Kahangoro had a deep passion for the community and their well-being. Kahangoro was the HR manager of the Oshinene Village Council at the time of his death and was once acting CEO of the village. Aneli Shiikwa, the Omaheke Infection Control focal person in the Health Ministry, said due care was exercised in the exhumation process as remains can still be infectious. Shiikwa said all those who handled the remains wore all the necessary PPE. The family bears the cost in this exhumation process.